that know the meaning of life, the search for meaning already gives the meaning to life. Nikolai Berdyaev, self-knowledge. So today I would like you to represent some part of the biography of the apostle of freedom, Nikolai Berdyaev, and how it influenced on the formation on his philosophy of marriage. Nikolai Berdyaev is political and religious thinker, and also he belongs to such a movement as personalistic school and existentialism. Let's say after Dostoevsky, he also opened the question about the problem, the existence of evil in this world, and also the reason of it. Briefly remind you that Berdyaev was born in Kyiv and was growing in a pretty aristocratic atmosphere. His mother was half a French, so at home usually they used French language. Ever he was a boy and having an access to father's library, he already read Schopenhauer, Hegel, Kant in original language. And it was already at the age of 14. One more nuance I forgot to mention is from the childhood of Nikolai, because he was a pretty sick child, what influenced on his further health, and he got a nervous tic. A few times during his life he was arrested and exiled. The very first time it happens in the university during his study years. Because of his belonging to the Marxist cycle, he, as many others, was appreciated of the Marxist ideas, and that's why he was arrested and, after all, was exiled. And the very first article he wrote it in German language, was published in the journal, Marxist journal, Neue Zeit, in 1899. But as an ripe Marxist, he raised the doubts about socialist ideology, and that's why made a shift from socialism to idealism. During the revolution of 1905 and 1917, he spends a lot of time on publication. Under his attention is the such a phenomenon, such idea as revolution. Exactly, he has a negative attitude towards revolution. He's saying that revolution means decrease, degradation, or even imprisonment of human spirit. Also, you can admit that from the beginning of the 20th century, his philosophical outlook becomes less and less political and more spiritual and metaphysical. In any way, the reason of all political upheavals he finds in the spiritual sphere. In 1904, Berdyaev met his future wife, Lydia, in Kyiv, and soon the couple got married. Also, at that time, she was already divorced. Lydia was from the aristocratic and orthodox family. She also was speaking French, and she was a supporter of Nikolai Berdyaev and the editor of his works. Also, she wrote the book Occupation, Wife of the Philosopher, where she describes the daily life of the family of Berdyaev. It is exactly written in the style of a diary. And there she kindly called Berdyaev Ni from Nikolai. In 1918, Lydia Berdyaeva got pneumonia. At this illness, she read the book about Saint Teresa from Avil. After that, she visited Greco-Catholic Church in Moscow, was inspired of the spirit of this community, and decided to become a Catholic. Nikolai supported her decision. In 1922, he was arrested and sent with his family to Berlin. In 2 years, they moved to France. The time at immigration was enough prolific. He organized his own academy, the Religious Philosophical Academy, together with Sergei Bulgakov and Jacques Maritain, set up the an ecumenical movement. Also, together with like-minded, he organized an Orthodox movement, L'Action Chrétienne des Étudiants Russes, which was supported by the voluntary organization YUMKA, really famous one. And also from 1925 till 1948 he was the editor of Yumka Press. Apart of this, in 1925 he started publishing his own journal, Put the Way. And in at his home in France, he organized meetings and discussions with different intellectuals of the time. So now I want to turn your attention on Bardyayev's outlook on marriage. So he is the singer who practices his philosophy in daily life. And if we talk about Nikolai Bardyayev and Lydia Bardyayeva, they were living together as married couple, normal couple, but in virginity. So they didn't have a sexual relationship. And exactly it was such a practice in Orthodox Christianity when couples stay together, married couples stay together, but they abstained of sex. Probably the most famous example is Saint John of Kronstadt and his wife Elizabeth. Then Nikolai and Lydia had a negative attitude on the sexual act, on pregnancy, which Lydia found really unesthetic, also on the birth. Bardyayev thinks that the one who gives birth dies and gives birth to the mortal. So all these nuances with bodily deficiencies and also the negative vision on sexual relationship influence on his philosophical ideas on marriage and also on love. Bardyayev thinks that it's really rarely when we can meet a real holy love in this world. Because in general, marriage and family is based on two principles, on social principle and physiological. Physiological aspect, let's say, presupposes the birth giving, and it leads to the continuation of family, or the birth giving also can destroy the family. And when we speak about the social dimension here, the family is under the social interest. So in our world, the marriage is rather a social construct, what has nothing to do exactly with pure love. So marriage is put on the altar of profanation. He thinks about treason, because social world is full of treason, and on his mind the treason doesn't exist in a spiritual love. So the purpose of unity between man and woman is to create a pure unity which leads the couple to eternity. In Bardyayev's vision, how people feel the world depends on sex. So in human sexuality, we can find the metaphysical roots of his existence. And here is important to differentiate between sexual energy and sex, male or female. Because sexual energy can be overcome, it can be redirected to creativity, but sex never. You are in this world or man or a woman. Point. And even in Christian symbolism, we can find this relation between male and female energies. For instance, when we speak about Logos and World Soul, or about Christ and His Church, or too about the Earth Bride and the Bridegroom Christ. But apart of this, Bardyayev thinks that we can find a pure unity of these two poles. And here he comes to speak about the androgyn. So based on this, the first man or the primordial man is androgyn, which represents the pure unity and creates the balance between the masculine and feminine. Also, the first man is an image of God in the full sense of this word. And also we can mention, we need to mention that by this view, Bardyayev is inspired by Jakob Böhme, the mystic of the 16th and 17th centuries. According to Böhme, the first man is sophistic. And three principles intersect in the first man: divine, human, and luciferic. Due to freedom and exaggeration of the dark luciferic principle, man loses his harmony. Therefore, the dead disappeared. Also, the opposite arised. For instance, the struggle between good and evil. Also, the history is born. And the task of man presupposes the recognition of divine in him and return to the original state. Probably the idea about androgyny was taken by Bohme from Kabbalistic teaching about Adam Kadmon, the first perfect unity and creation of God, the image and likeness of God. But it's not necessary that Bohme's view is fully Kabbalistic, because as some researchers prove, his view is built on hermeneutic tradition as well, and first of all on a doctrine so-called rabbis. It's about an alchemical marriage of king and queen. In Christian teaching we also can find this androgynic intention, for instance proposed by Saint Maximus of Confessor. Then in Bourdieu's view about love and marriage, human is neither a man nor a woman, but unity of both. And here is going first of all about spiritual unity. Let us think about it and let the universe support you. See you next time. God bless you.